Yo guys, what's happening and welcome back to another video. And in today's video, what I'm going to be talking to you about, the best beginner DSLRs that you can get. Now let's get right into this video. Now before this video starts, if you guys want to know what I use to create this content, the links to buy them are down below. And if you guys also want to help me reach my goal of 500 subscribers by the end of the year, hashtag drive to 500 and consider subscribing. But let's get right into this video. So first let me say, what do you consider an entry-level DSLR? Well, an entry-level one is like the basically the ones that are set out for beginners. They're not super expensive and there is quite a few of them. In Canon's line, there's the 1000 ones, the 1000, 2000, I think, something like that. The lesser the numbers, the better quality the camera is. First beginner DSLR I'm going to talk about is the Canon 700D. The Canon 700D is an amazing beginner DSLR, and here is the features of this camera. The Canon 700D has a flip out screen, which is very, very helpful for basically so you can easily see whatever angle you're shooting at. It's very, very good for if you need to see what you're shooting, if you need to shoot a low angle, or if you need to shoot towards yourself and need to see if you're framed up properly. It's very, very helpful and it's a great feature to have. All Canon cameras should have this feature because it's just a must have. And the next feature is that this camera shoots in 1080p at 24 frames a second and 720p at 60 frames per second, so you can get your slow-mo. Now this is a great quality image for YouTube or for filmmaking. I have lots of clips of just using this because before the 80D, this is the camera I used all the time. So here's a few clips now of what this kind of footage looks like. I'll be holding you. Also, after you've seen all that juicy footage from that camera, and the next feature you have is a mic jack, so you can add an external mic on top of the camera. And obviously I'm shooting on the Canon 80D for this video because that's what I shoot all my videos on now, but the mic jack in a Canon 700D, this bad boy, having that feature is incredible, because if you have that, you can have your external mic on the camera and you get lots of better audio and stuff like that. Another good feature that it has is an EFS mount, which means it'll fit all your EF lenses, all your EFS lenses, so it can fit into all the Canon professional EF lenses, all because of the mount that it has. And due to this, if you're using a full frame lens, for example, this one, the Nifty 50, it will be a 1.6 crop, I think it is. And essentially that means you're essentially got an 85mm or an 80mm lens, but you can still get very, very good image because that's what an APS-C sensor does, because it's not a full frame sensor. But there is specific lenses, like the lens I'm shooting on now, which is good for APS-C sensors because it's an EFS lens. So it is amazing. Very, very good. Another good feature of this camera is the fact that it has a small-ish body. It's like the Canon 80D is like almost the size of a 5D. It's quite big, but the Canon 700D has a much smaller body. You wouldn't notice it by seeing it, but this has quite a small-ish body. It's not super massive, and I think this is a very, very good thing for this camera. The fact that the body is nice and light. It's not super heavy, and it's very good for obviously vlogging and stuff like that. And all the accessories you can have on it, if you have your lighter body, it means you've got less to carry. But it's such a good thing to have a smallish body and make it sure it's kind of light. And now the last thing about this camera is the fact that this camera is pretty cheap for a DSLR. And the thing is, when you're buying film gear and stuff, I know all the prices might be a bit daunting, but since I got this camera, the Canon 700D a couple of years ago. I got it for about 400 with the kit lens. It was about £400. And right now, the cheapest you could probably find it new is between the £400 range. So it's never dropped one bit. Like, I think that is astonishing. So you're never going to lose money out in it. And if you use it obviously for making stuff and you eventually make money off your photography or your video stuff, you're gonna eventually pay for, the camera's gonna pay for itself anyway. Now I've took that for a shoot before. Here's the image of it. I had it on a big lens and stuff. I'll show you the image now. You can basically rig it up with anything. You just can have a cage, you can have anything because of all the different mount and how basically good it is for any situation. Now let's move on to the next camera that I'm going to talk about. Canon M50. Unfortunately, I don't actually have the Canon M60, but I know the features and I know that this is a very, very good camera. If anybody whatsoever wants to send me one of them, I will gladly take it and properly review it. And I'll list the features of the Canon M50 and why it is such a good camera. Again, it has that flip out screen, which is absolutely amazing. Obviously for your vlogging or if you're low angles and all that, I said it in the last thing. It has 4K, well it shoots 4K-ish. And the reason I say ish is because it shoots 4K, but when it shoots 4K, obviously the APS-C sensor already is a crop, but it crops it another 1.5 times. So it's gonna make it slightly harder for some different shots and stuff. So the Canon M60 4K, when I say ish, I mean ish, because it shoots 4K, but it's super, super, super cropped. But it also does, it's full HD 1080p, 24 frames a second and 60 frames per second. The Canon 80D does this as well. Yeah, so it's a full 1080p 24 and a full 1080p 60 frames per second. And for that super juicy slow-mo, you can get, at 720p, you can get 120 frames a second. Now that is amazing for a camera at this price point and this size. It is astonishing. It is so, so good. And even just that feature of 120 frames, I'm not caring if it's a 720p, that is an astonishing feature. The only cameras that really kind of do this is the 1DX and I think the Canon 5D Mark IV. They are £4,000 cameras, £5,000 cameras, I think some of them are even £6,000 cameras, and this one is nowhere near that price and it does 120 frames a second. You can't understand how amazing this is. And that is one of the biggest features this camera has. Another thing it has is obviously the mic jack for your external mics for better audio, but the audio of the thing itself has front facing mics, so it comes towards you. And this is amazing due to the fact that the audio coming off this camera is amazing without a mic. Just with a mic will enhance it so much, and the capability to add it in is right on the side of the camera, which is brilliant. Another feature that this camera has is it has dual pixel autofocus, which this means it's essentially, it has so many autofocus points that it is very, very, very fast for autofocusing. For example, this is the Canon 80D's dual pixel autofocus. It's the same feature and you'll see what I mean. Look at this. Super quick. Do you know what I mean? It's one of the features that is in most new Canon cameras, which is amazing and is very, very much needed. And that's what made me think to upgrade to the Canon 80D is because the Canon 700D didn't have this. And the fact that this little mirrorless camera has this is astonishing. So as I say, and the next thing, it is mirrorless, meaning there's no mirror, which means the body can be smaller. I think this thing is about this size. It's tiny. It is so, so tiny. And it makes it nice and light for your bag if you only need a light kit and you only take a small camera that packs a punch. This is it. It is so, so, so good. and it also has Wi-Fi capabilities. Now this means when you're out on a shoot or you're filming something, you download the Canon Connect app. You connect your phone to that, you will get access to all the photos you've took, all the images, all the videos, and store it to your phone, which is amazing. You'll be able to have this feature of taking anything you took with you on your shoot straight to your phone. You can edit it, put it on Instagram like that instantly. It is amazing, and that feature is great. I used that on the 80D. It is amazing. This has, and the best thing about this camera is it is only £440 to buy. Now that is the cheapest I have found it, and that's with a kit lens as well. The only downside to this camera is it has a special EFM mount, and an EFM means you do not get access to the big professional lenses, but you can buy the Canon, official Canon mount. That means you can go from an EFM to an EFS, I think it is, which means you get access to all the lenses. Also, that's an extra thing you've got to buy, you don't get that with it. But I hope these two cameras that I've mentioned to you have been very, very helpful, because if I didn't buy the 700D, I'd have probably took a look at the M50, because it's just an amazing camera. And I hope this video helped you guys in deciding what you're going to get for your entry-level DSLR or mirrorless camera. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below. If you guys want to tell me what you thought of this video, please leave a comment down below. And also, if you guys know when my videos come out first, click that notification bell so that you guys can stay notified. It's right next to the subscribe button. And talking about that, if you guys want to help me reach my goal of 500 subscribers by the end of the year, hashtag drive to 500 and consider subscribing. But you guys are awesome, and peace.